I've been fighting for 6 years now. Every day, I wake up at 5 a.m. to go train. I'd run sometimes along beaches, sometimes up mountain trails, until 6 a.m. and then start my Muay Thai training. I'd train until 7 o'clock and then go to school. I'd finish school at about 3:30, then I'll come back to the gym and train from 4 to 8:30 in the evening. When I was 9, I had a neighbor who was a boxer, and every day he ran past our house. So one day, I ran after him to where he trained, Phet Lung Rueang Camp, and that's how I got into boxing. They took me in, taught me how to box. Most camps would ask for money, but these guys would never ask me for anything. It wasn't famous camp. It was just another small, typical Thai boxing camp. Kids train here for free. I started fighting at exhibitions after a few months. I wasn't paid. The only money I got from fighting there were from tourists who gave me tips. I had my first fight at a real stadium when I was 11. These fights were about 1,000 baht or $32 each. When I was 13, I started to compete in Bangkok for 8,000 baht or $250. As I won more and more fights, they started to pay me more. My last fight, I was paid 18,000 baht. That's about $580. Although I'm 15, but because of my large build, I'm fighting guys who are in their 20s. It takes a lot of training to fight people who have been training and fighting for years. I must commit myself. Plenty of times when I'm training or fighting, I feel like I don't want to be there. And I often think that I can't take any of this any longer. For me, to always know the position I'm in, it gives me a lift, an encouragement, and that has always and will always influence my reasons for fighting. Family is poor. We can't afford a proper education. I go to a temple school and my brother and sister, they go to a public school. My dad delivered gas for a living and he doesn't make much. That's also how I got my boxing name, Bothathaw. The only other source of income we get is from my fights. It's a rule that boxers must have a resting period between fights. That means that I can only have one fight each month. It's never enough. I guess it's the same everywhere in Thailand though. We all have the same background. Only a few could make it to the big time. Many people quit boxing because of this. It's a tough sport, and there are so many reasons to quit. I've seen many boxers my age giving up because of girls or drugs. Some of them just get lazy and don't want to do it anymore. For me, I just can't quit. It's just not that easy for me. Every boxer has this drive to fight against the limits of choices they have in hoping that they can give what is best for their families and themselves. It's a spiritual fight against everyone else in a position basically no different than from mine. Point was when I was 12. It was 3 years ago and it was my worst year. I lost every single fight and I was thinking about quitting, I still hung around the camp and helped younger kids train. I did that for 2 whole months. Then this one time, when I went to one of the kids' fight, one of the fights opened up and they were looking for someone to fill in. I had around the same build they were looking for, so it was agreed that I'd fight. That night, I won. And from then on, I have been winning almost every single fight. My greatest goal is to fight in a renowned program like the Thai fight. I don't know how long until my body can take this no longer and I have to quit. It is my only wish that I can achieve my goals before then. What will I do when I can no longer box? What can I do today if not boxing? I just don't have an answer for that. Boxing has always been my life. My name is B and I'm a boxer.